Yo, what's up everybody? V-Live coming back at it with another bonsai video. Today we're going to be working on this maple. Now if you guys have seen the mystical garden walkthrough, then this will look a little bit familiar. We have been letting this pretty much just grow out, no work done, so you can see it's grown pretty wild. And in this, we're just going to give it its first basic maintenance and prune. Start out by just getting a little bit more light into the trunk and clean it up a little bit, and pretty much just walk you through. So we're just looking at it. There's a lot going on, and when working with trees, one thing to keep in mind is the lower half is stronger than the top half, so you could take a little bit more off of the lower than you can the top. So I'm gonna just first go through and find all the damaged leaves and pretty much cut those off, or weak leaves, whatnot. So like this one right here, we probably let this one go. And then with some of these, I'm gonna put them right back into the soil for the tree. Now when you're pruning a tree, you're going to want some basic tools. When you're just working with container grown, you can just do a simple pair of shears like this. And then I also like to have some branch cutters on deck. Some concave ones preferably is going to help you get a much cleaner cut. I'm going to let the tree heal a lot better and smoother. Like this leaf right here. Now you don't want to cut it all the way back. You just want to cut it back to one of the buds. I'm going to bring you right in here. If it focuses. And I don't want to focus, but when you cut it, you'll see where it branches off. You don't want to cut it all the way back to the tree. You want to leave some of the stem there so it grows. A little bit easier for it to bud right back. That off. I cut that back to the first pair. And the last something about one of the videos is some cuttings. You could use something like this as a cutting before the wood turns to hardwood. What you would just do is pull these off. Probably take that one off also and leave those two. We'll cut that though, and you just peel this back down to the bud, expose the bud some. Probably not going to use a cutting for this one, this is just a demonstration. You can just use your fingernail for real. You just want to expose that bud. Use some rooting hormone. And use some rooting hormone, sit down some soil, wait probably like a month, and it should, if it doesn't root, then it'll dry out before then. But if it roots, then it's gonna stay around. You'll know pretty quick if it's gonna root or not. Just take off some of this extra growth here. And we're gonna cut that back. this one back. Right now I'm just cleaning out some of the top, get some shade into it. And the spots that are crowded, probably gonna free them up. This one back down to the bud. See, now I'll probably use this as a cutting. Yeah, so we'll probably just come in here. Well, I don't know, it's because they want all that bud for some roots. And we'll just come here, cut that off. And now we'll start scraping. Now I'm gonna be right back and go get me some rooting hormone. Went there, dipped it in some rooting hormone, some basic rooting powder, nothing too fancy. I'm gonna go ahead and sit this. That in the soil. Now we'll wait, see if it grows, and we'll keep you guys up to date with that. Right, so now we'll get back to work here. A lot of these can make some good cutting, but we're not gonna make cutting out of everything. It's okay, just cut it and let it go. Alright, let's go over here. We'll probably just cut that whole thing off. We'll have a bunch of cutting from there. Go ahead and drop that right there into the soil. As you can see, there's just a lot going on with this tree. But it has been given some time to grow. Get what it means. I'm actually going to clean this up right here. I'm going to go get me some. All right, we got some cut paste now so we can make some cuts. I'm gonna come in here, let y'all see what we're actually about to do. So I'm gonna get the leader side more over here. So I'm about to just clean up this section right here, make a nice clean cut right there, get that out the way. Clear out the top a little bit, open it up some, and get some of this unnecessary movement out the way. Go ahead, cut that. And let's go ahead, cut some of these leaves. I'm gonna go in here, drop them right in there. This is why I like the concave cutters. Make some cuts right here. Nice and clean, and it should heal up pretty straight with the tree. Depending on the type of year, the time of year that you're in will depend on when you'll want to do some cuts like these and open the tree up. Because it can grow, heal a little bit quicker, and repair itself a little bit faster when it's in a time like this and the tree is healthy. You don't want to do work on a tree like this if your tree is not healthy, because you will stress it out even more and possibly kill it. Unless there, I'll show you guys here in a little bit. There's a situation where I thought one of my trees was going to die. It was getting really, really weak leaves, so all of it. So I went ahead and did a complete defoliation of it. And now it's popping out some beautiful new budding. So I know we didn't lose the tree. It just had a weak set of leaves that needed to get out of there to push out some new. Oh, that's just gushed right out. Get a little bit on my finger right here. Get that wound covered. And voila. And now, let y'all see after we made the cut and got the cut paste. And now we got some more space up in the canopy area. So now we're gonna start making our way down into the tree a little bit more. Let's go ahead. All right, we're gonna clean this part up right here. Dang it, cut a branch that didn't move. That's why you gotta be very, very careful. I know this tree will grow it right back. But yeah, that was a... Yeah, we're gonna turn this into a cutting now. That's for sure. Alright, so let's go ahead, cut some of this back. Maybe like that twin trunk. Go ahead, peel back.
close that there. And now this should make a pretty nice tree in the future. And you just take your cutting after you've done that, dip it in your rooting hormone, and go over and put in some soil. So I'll be right back.
Make sure that your cuttings, you leave them in some shade so that they don't just get burnt and just dry out and die. They keep moisture inside. So now they're going to clean out the whole part. Go all the way with it. Now, reason for cut paste is it keeps the moisture inside of the tree. It almost acts as a bandage and it helps it just seal up nice and clean. And it also prevents infections and whatnot. So I like to use it on some of the more, pretty much the cuts that are near the trunk. Or it opens up the tree a little bit more than what it would like. But maybe that cut didn't need to be. Now we're just going to come in here and let the canopy sun. What I was doing with this part right over here, is I'll come bring you guys in real quick, is I was cleaning off the lower branches because I want these to develop and grow out a little bit more. So I want to take the energy from the lower part of it and disperse it to the top and continue to push that out some. So we'll have to see how it grows. When you're pruning your trees, you want to make sure that you're pruning intentionally so you do not harm the tree. Don't just come in here. Try to make your random cuts. You want to observe and learn your tree. And see how it grows, because everyone grows so much different than the other. They can be grown from a similar seed, but still grow a little bit different. So you want to pretty much nurture it, see how it grows, and then once you get pruned and whatnot. Sometimes it's better just to let your tree grow versus always trying to prune it. I know it could be fun, but it's also fun just stepping back, taking care of it, giving it what it needs so it can grow and take off. And then you can go on and start shaping and styling it up. So. But if you don't have nothing to shape and style, what you gonna do? You gonna cut that off. Pretty confident.
That's also gonna push some new buds out. Since we're still in the middle of the growing season, we're not slowing down anytime soon. So I thought it'd be the best time to come and do a pruning on it, a maintenance, because I've been wanting to bring it to y'all, see how the transition goes.
Pretty big up in here. So just come and cut out the suckers. Going straight up.
I don't want to do a hole too much because I want to wait the branch selection for winter when it goes dormant. So I can really see what the tree going on with. But I know that I do need to clean it up some. So that's what we're doing today. Pretty much when it's something like this, if you're not sure where to start, just start with all the damaged parts. With all the damaged leaves that are taken away from the aesthetic of the tree. And then you can kind of start seeing as it develops and grows. That's the way it kind of wants to go. I mean, you can just follow the pattern of the tree. A little bit. Now I don't really like to spray too much on my trees, so you might see some fuzz on that, on some of your trees, your maples, I forget what they're called, but you can go through, spray them with like some neem oil or even just some soap and water, just get them off, or you can even just rub them with your finger. But sometimes I'll just let some of the animals just be living and chilling on the trees, because out in nature you don't really have nobody going through and monitoring every single thing that goes on with the tree. So sometimes it's best to just let it be, do its thing, just make sure it has water and the nutrients that it needs to grow. And then what you can do is you start getting to it where you some like another just basic prune that you could do is a technique. It's just you can just cut every other leaf off, every other pair. And what I mean by that is if you come here, since we talked about in the soil and the seeds how the maples they grow every other one, so you can come here. Find a set of leaves, like these two. You got one right here, one right here. You would take one of those off and leave the other one. And that's alternating sets. Whatever you do one side, you do to the other. Now I'll probably just speed this up and get back to you guys after we have finished up with the cleanup. because that branch coming off of. So this is what the tree's looking like so far. As you guys can tell, we opened it up a lot, but there's still a little bit more to get done real quick before I'm gonna say this tree is good to continue resting for the season and growing. Alright, so we're gonna get right back to it. Bye.
get out the way of the camera. Now you guys want to make sure that you do prune your trees, because it will promote stronger growth and new growth, and it will help development throughout the years. So I could have just left this keep on growing, but then it probably would have got out of hand and some of it would have started dying it out. This does help strengthen it up. Like some, I've done a couple, pruned a couple trees, and I've seen it for myself that it does make what is there a little bit stronger. So there is a reason for pruning. Pretty much is what I wanted to get at. Thank you. And there we have it. The first initial shape of, and style of this maple tree. Now I'm gonna go through and just add some cut paste to all these wounds right there. But we'll just go ahead. Now in the winter time, I'm gonna go ahead and wire this up, wire some of these branches. For now, I just wanna give it that shape. I'm just pruning up. You see all these beautiful new growth. It's only going to flourish even more now. And it should back bud up in here. Now we can actually see some of these branching. Very beautiful. Now I'm not gonna do too much wiring with it, probably just move branches down and out the way. But as you can see, it's already gained some twists and curves itself. So I'll probably just do more of the clip and grow method to get this to grow out different ways. And we'll see what happens throughout the time frame. Go ahead and just cut that off real quick. Alright, so yeah, that's it for the video. Hope you guys are getting out with nature and tuning in and have enjoyed watching these videos. I know me personally, I've enjoyed it. I've pretty much waited my entire life to get to this stage. So now, it only is going to keep going, and see what comes from it. I'm going to prune real quick. Well, like always, appreciate everybody that's been tuning in and watching these videos. Hopefully you guys have been able to learn something. I know that I have. I know that there's always more to learn. It's an art form that is never done. Always more stages to it. I'm gonna just leave that alone now. I'm gonna let that grow. Alright, so yeah, we're gonna leave that like that, how it is. You guys go ahead and see that if it wants to focus. Yup, and there we have it. Now we got some air and light flowing through there, and we can start strengthening up and developing a little bit more. Excited to see where this tree goes. Like I said, all this branching is new. When I first got it, it was literally just a straight stick. I'll probably post the original picture in this video clip, probably at the beginning, let you guys see that. For those that stay tuned,
appreciate y'all. Enjoy the day. One love. Live to the fullest.